Hello and welcome to Comparative VPN YouTube channel. This video will be an in-depth review of ProtonVPN. ProtonVPN isn't the most popular VPN on the market. However, those who know what ProtonVPN is know that this provider is focused merely on privacy and security. Namely, this VPN has more than 1,000 servers and is based in Switzerland. Moreover, the service is well known for its Proton mail service, but also its secure core servers that aim to increase your privacy and security online to the highest possible level. Before we start our ProtonVPN review, we need to mention one thing, and that is that ProtonVPN comes in two variants. You can get a paid version and you can get a free version. In this review, we're going to talk about a ProtonVPN free version, but of course, as always, we'll also go over some paid plans and see whether or not ProtonVPN is worth a buy. So, without further ado, let's see what ProtonVPN has to offer and see how good or bad it actually is. Let's start off our test by talking about app compatibility. Being a not very popular VPN, ProtonVPN can't really brag about its huge and overwhelming app compatibility. In fact, this VPN supports just a few platforms, including desktop and mobile platforms. So, right off the bat, you can say goodbye to routers, smart TVs, and even your gaming consoles. Yes, we know that's a bit of a problem, but hey, ProtonVPN, as mentioned, isn't a top-of-the-line provider, so some corners must be cut. As we can see here, you can use Windows, Mac OS, Linux, and Chromebook. Moving on, ProtonVPN also has apps for Android and iOS. These apps are native, so you don't need any third-party OpenVPN software to configure it. Instead, just click here or here to download Android or iOS apps, and the VPN will automatically transfer you to either Google Play or Apple Store, depending on your preferred platform. So, in terms of app compatibility, ProtonVPN surely won't blow you away. But what about the app? Well, let's see how good and easy to use it is. At a first glance, ProtonVPN reminds us of NordVPN. The reason for that is that the app layout is pretty much the same. On the right, you have a huge world map, and on the left, you have a server list that you can scroll down using your mouse wheel. Now, the question is, how do you connect to the server? Well, it's quite simple. You just place your cursor on the server you want and click on connect. Then, ProtonVPN shows this window and you just need to click on enable to establish a connection. After a few seconds, ProtonVPN establishes a connection and as you can see right here, we got a new IP address. To disconnect, simply click here and once again click on enable to stop the connection. Now, what about other settings? Well, to access them, we need to click here and then click on the settings menu. These are all just general settings, and generally speaking, they're not very relevant for our review. But what if we move on to the connection menu? Well, here we can see that ProtonVPN actually offers one protocol. Yeah, they're offering just OpenVPN, but in two variants, TCP and UDP. To be honest, that doesn't matter a lot because, for example, if you want to bypass the Great Firewall of China, this will be practically impossible using strictly OpenVPN. This is because the Great Firewall is very effective against OpenVPN and it can easily detect it, blocking the internet access completely. When accessing the Advanced Settings menu, we can see that there are many options that ProtonVPN offers. The first one is a VPN kill switch, then we have DNS leak protection and IPv6 leak protection, and both of them are available in the free version. Another set of features include alternative routing and split tunneling. Split tunneling is a very popular feature that you can find on ExpressVPN, Surfshark, CyberGhost, and pretty much every premium VPN. Luckily, split tunneling here is usable even on a free account and lets you choose which part of your connection to route through a VPN tunnel and which part you'll use by using your native IP address. Moving on with our ProtonVPN review, it's time to do a speed test. As a reference, we use our native internet speed, which is basically our internet speed without using any VPN. And as you can see, our native internet speed is displayed right here. Given that ProtonVPN has only 3 servers in its free version, we're going to use one server in Europe and one server abroad. The server in Europe will be the one in the Netherlands, and then once we test this server, we'll connect to the US server and see how good or bad the speeds are overseas. So let's get back into the app, click on the Netherlands, and then click on connect to establish a connection. With the Dutch IP address in place, we just need to minimize this window and return to the speed test. Back to the speed test, and you can really see that we are using a server in Amsterdam. So now just click on go to initiate the speed test. We can see that our speed test results are really, really bad. In fact, we can say that they're exceptionally bad. Although the ping isn't very high, our download and upload speeds are severely decreased, which makes ProtonVPN not suitable for torrenting or streaming. Nevertheless, let's disconnect from the Dutch server and try out the US server. Let's do so by clicking here and then using the connection button. We got a US IP address, so let's just minimize this app and refresh the page to repeat the test. Let's click on go now. And now the situation is pretty interesting. ProtonVPN once again managed to surprise us, but this time positively. As we can see, the speed while using the US server is significantly faster than the Dutch server. Sure, the ping skyrocketed to more than 100 milliseconds, but on the other hand, our download and upload speeds aren't really bad. Of course, that is when compared to the previous result. On the other hand, if we compare ProtonVPN to ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and CyberGhost, these speeds are all but great. Speaking of which, ExpressVPN is a much faster VPN, and if you want a premium provider, we suggest this option. Sure, you'll pay for ExpressVPN, but on the other hand, it gives you a 49% discount and 3 months free for the annual plan. On top of that, you get a 30-day money-back guarantee, which lets you get a refund in case you don't like ExpressVPN or you don't need it anymore. To get this deal, simply use the following link: comparative-vpn.fr/evpn, or you can just click on the link in the description to get it. It's time to continue our ProtonVPN review by performing a streaming test. Being a free VPN, ProtonVPN isn't really known for its outstanding streaming capabilities, but that doesn't always mean that the VPN isn't functional enough. As you can see in the app, once again, we connected to the US server, and this here is Netflix, a widely popular streaming platform. While connected to the US server, we accessed Netflix to see if it works. And seemingly, at the first glance, it really works. But what if we want to stream a particular show or movie? Well, let's see. As always, let's try The Witcher and see if it works. Surprisingly, Witcher really works. And to be honest, speeds for streaming aren't really that bad. Another platform we want to test out is called ABC. ABC, as some of you know, is a very popular American streaming platform where you can access many shows and movies, but also watch live streams of many sports events. Now that we've entered the website, let's see if we can actually watch anything. We can click on this show here and see if it works. Well, unfortunately, ProtonVPN isn't able to unblock ABC, as you can see here. The platform gives us an error saying that there is a problem with our network location settings. In other words, the platform detected that we are using a VPN and it blocked our access immediately. In terms of other streaming platforms, ProtonVPN, as said, isn't going to blow you away. Sure, you'll be able to watch Netflix US, but when it comes to other platforms such as BBC iPlayer, ABC, Amazon Prime Video, Hulu, and Disney Plus, you can forget about them. In this case, ExpressVPN is once again a much better solution. Based in Switzerland, ProtonVPN has a lot going for it. First of all, Switzerland is a really good VPN jurisdiction because it's outside of the 49s and therefore has strict privacy laws. But let's see what are actually the security features in the app. First of all, ProtonVPN comes with military-grade encryption, which is also used by banks and military. Moreover, this VPN has IPv6 and DNS leak protection, which will help you keep your privacy and security online. The highlight of this VPN, however, is its Secure Core feature. And Secure Core, make no mistake, is a fancy name for a multi-hop feature. Multi-hop is a feature we saw in Surfshark, and what it basically does is route your connection through multiple servers. In this case, ProtonVPN routes your connection through 3 servers, so basically when you connect, your connection bounces off from one server to another, and then back to the first one. This is really great for privacy, as no one will be able to track your IP and see what you're doing online. Furthermore, Secure Core servers are located in Switzerland and are ProtonVPN's proprietary servers. This makes them far more secure and suitable for privacy lovers. Once again, we can see that ProtonVPN says that it supports only OpenVPN despite IKEV2 and other protocols being cheaper to maintain. But ProtonVPN claims that OpenVPN is really the best solution and therefore they're sticking to it strictly. Another great thing about ProtonVPN is its support for Tor over VPN. So basically, when you connect to the VPN, you can easily use Tor browser to be able to browse the deep web or dark web safely. And finally, ProtonVPN claims to have a real zero logging policy, which should be great news for privacy enthusiasts. But is ProtonVPN really a no-log provider? Well, let's see. As we can see in the privacy policy, ProtonVPN really is a no-log provider. It doesn't store any of your browsing data, IP addresses, and other compromising information. However, ProtonVPN also mentions that it stores a single timestamp of your recent login. Basically, once you connect to the server, ProtonVPN stores the exact time you did that, and that's all. After that, as soon as your connection is established, ProtonVPN really won't connect your used bandwidth, websites you visit, browsing history, outgoing and inbound IP addresses, and pretty much any other information that could be linked to you. So, ProtonVPN is indeed a no-log VPN, which is really great, especially because you can use it for free and still remain safe and secure online. To bolster our claims, we decided to do an IP and DNS leak test to see if ProtonVPN is able to keep you safe and secure. Well, as you can see, we first used a website called ipleak.net. And here, we can see that ProtonVPN passes the test with flying colors. Another website we used is called dnsleaktest.com. And here, once again, this VPN is pretty successful. Now, when it comes to torrenting, this is a very important thing we need to mention in our ProtonVPN review. Namely, if you're using a free version of ProtonVPN, you can pretty much forget about torrenting. The reason being is because any of these free servers you get are not P2P friendly. So, if you just want to enjoy torrenting, you can pretty much forget about ProtonVPN and using its free plan. But what about buying ProtonVPN? Isn't it going to allow you to download torrents? Well, it is. However, not all servers are P2P friendly, and therefore you need to choose special torrenting servers after which you'll be able to download torrents. But then again, we saw that this VPN really isn't the fastest, and in fact it's very slow, so don't expect extraordinary performance. When it comes to bypassing censorship, ProtonVPN once again is a really disappointing choice. Why? Well, you can see why exactly on the screen. As of September 2019, we can see that China officially blocked ProtonVPN. So basically, if you travel to China or any censored country, you can expect that ProtonVPN isn't going to work. One of the reasons for that is a strict use of OpenVPN. The Great Firewall of China is especially effective against OpenVPN. OpenVPN in the past few years became really easy to detect, and therefore it's not the best option for bypassing censorship. IKEV2, on the other hand, is a slightly better choice, but once again, ProtonVPN doesn't support it, and therefore is not a reliable option in this regard. Is ProtonVPN going to impress you when it comes to servers? Well, not exactly. As you can see, this VPN has around 1000 servers in 54 countries around the world. This number itself isn't really bad, but considering its expensive price, which we're going to talk about later, it's a really small server network. Before we talk about pricing in our ProtonVPN review, we need to go over its customer support team, which is, well, as you can see, available only through email. Yes, ProtonVPN doesn't have live chat support, which is a huge downside if you ask us. Live chat support is necessary if you want to get quick help for your urgent issues. But this won't be possible when using ProtonVPN because you need to use a contact form, type in your question and send it to the customer support team. The customer support team, although not the slowest we've seen, isn't the fastest either. In fact, you'll even wait for up to 24 hours to get a response, in which time you can simply visit this knowledge base here and find the solution yourself. ProtonVPN support is one of its weakest points. As we can see on the screen, ProtonVPN is far from being the cheapest out there. Apart from this free plan, we have a basic plan that costs 4 euros. And if we look down, we can see that this plan isn't really good when it comes to features. You get 2 simultaneous connections, servers in 50 countries, high speeds, allegedly, no logs, no ads, and P2P BitTorrent support. On the other hand, we have a plus plan, which costs 8 euros per month, and here you get everything we said, with the addition of secure core VPN servers, Tor over VPN, and access to blocked content, which once again isn't guaranteed because ProtonVPN isn't great in terms of bypassing geo restrictions. Lastly, we have a visionary plan that costs whopping 24 euros a month. This is really, really expensive, but this plan comes with all the features we mentioned, plus 10 VPN connections in Proton Mail visionary account. If you don't really need Proton Mail account and 10 simultaneous connections, a visionary plan is a waste of money. If you want to get a 2-year plan with ProtonVPN, the pricing is a bit different, but then again, it's very expensive, especially when compared to CyberGhost or Surfshark. And yet, these two VPNs offer much more features, better speeds, more servers, and great P2P support. So, at this price, is ProtonVPN really worth a buy? Well, it's actually not. With everything said, let's wrap up our ProtonVPN review and see whether or not it's worth your time and money. ProtonVPN is really good when it comes to security and privacy. And on top of that, the VPN offers an easy-to-use app for all platforms, which is great for beginners. Sadly, apart from that, this VPN doesn't really have many good things going for it. Although it unblocks US Netflix, not many other platforms will be unblockable. Furthermore, ProtonVPN isn't a P2P friendly VPN, and you also get just 1,000 servers around the world. As the icing on the cake, this VPN is really expensive even when compared to ExpressVPN. And yet, its features and overall performance is vastly inferior to any of the VPNs we just mentioned. The first question now is whether ProtonVPN is worth your time. Well, if you're going to invest time in ProtonVPN, beware that free version doesn't let you download torrents, and although it offers unlimited bandwidth, it's pretty limited and offers just 3 server locations. So yeah, ProtonVPN is worth your time as a free VPN, but then again, Windscribe is a much better choice, and therefore, we recommend Windscribe instead of ProtonVPN. Now, is ProtonVPN worth your money? The answer to that question is once again, no. Why? Because there are many better premium VPNs out there, and one of them is ExpressVPN that you can easily get by clicking on the link in the description below. ExpressVPN, although not the cheapest VPN, still vastly outperforms ProtonVPN in pretty much every aspect. With that in mind, ProtonVPN is not worth a buy, but if you need a solid free VPN with a zero logging policy and great security features, then ProtonVPN is worth considering. That was all for our ProtonVPN review. We hope you liked it, and if you did, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and stick with us because many more VPN reviews are coming soon. See you in the next video. Bye!